There's a huge diversity of parasites, but us ecologists divide them simply into small ones and large ones. And that distinction is fundamental. The small ones, the microparasites, are the viruses, the bacteria, the fungi. These breed within the host. They're short-lived. They quite often kill the host. And quite often they result in immunity afterwards. So it's a short but nasty infection. And because of the shortness of it, there's a necessity to have new victims to spread the disease onto. So they're characteristic of species that live in dense populations, such as seabirds and colonial breeders. And this is the Farne Islands, and they've just recovered from a harrowing 2 years in which they picked up 10,000 individuals with avian flu, a virus. And this is a typical microparasite outbreak. And we can count the number of individuals as uninfected or infected and then immune and died. And that spread of the disease can be described by counting those different categories. The large ones, macroparasites, flukes, various sorts of worms, and these are long-lived. They don't reproduce within the host. They often have complex life cycles and reproduce in relation to another host. If you think of tapeworms, so it's long-lived, rather unpleasant life cycle. It's not useful to think about infected or not. We want to think of the parasite burden and how that changes over time, and particularly the individuals with high parasite loads, as that's where the infection's really serious. So the distinction between microparasites and macroparasites is critical when thinking about population ecology.